San Francisco State University Finance 372, Team 2, Take 2, and Action.
Hi, my name is Christine Johnson, and these are my teammates.
Mina Chong.
Angelica Bonda.
And tonight we'll be presenting Essex. The current intrinsic value of 249 is currently higher than the current price of 234. And based on our research, we recommend to buy. Tonight we'll be going over the background, SWOT analysis, financial conditions, stock valuations, and lastly, recommending our trades. Essex is a public company that is currently traded on the New York Stock Exchange. It was founded in 1971, and it primarily focuses on residential properties. It acquires, develops, redevelops, and manages multifamily apartment communities. It scores high in walkability, and its normal property types are friendly and comfortable communities in Southern California, Northern California, and Seattle. Their CEO is Michael Schall, Vice President and Chief Financial Officer Angela Kleiman, Chief Investment Officer John Udy, Chief Investment Officer Craig Zimmerman, and their Senior Vice President John Burkrat. Their strategy is to have a disciplined, research-driven approach to investing in supply-constrained markets in the West Coast. And now Mina will take you into the rankings for us.
Okay. So Essex ranks third, following Avalon Bay and Equity Residential at $16.6 billion. Their SWOT analysis for their strengths, they have existing distribution networks, sustainability with water and energy efficient programs, where they receive $5 million for over 100 of their partners, or 100 of their properties through partnerships. And their weakness is high loan rates, low investments in R&D, and low profitability. Opportunities are growth rates. Threats include high competition, rising costs of raw materials, and high overhead costs. Financial condition, their equity ratios are overall excellent and good. Their growth rate is mainly excellent except for EPS net growth. Overall, their financial condition is excellent. For profitability, they scored average, and for leverage is average as well, so overall average. For their technical analysis, their stock price in April was $234, and their target price would be $264 in April of 2018 at a 2% growth rate, premium of 11%, upward trending and rising RSI and MACD. I'm going to pass it over to Angelica.
Okay, so I'll be talking about evaluations. The first one I'll be talking about is our perpetuity model. Based on our CAPM model, we came up with a return of 7%. And here's our FFOs for 2018 through 2020. And using a return of 6%, we got $236 as our stock value. When comparing it to the current price of $234, it's a premium of 1%. Next one is supporting growth. Again, here's our CAPM model with a return of 7% for expected. And then our FFOs, and using the matrix, we decided on the middle number, which is 284. Comparing it to the current price, it is a premium of 17%. Next one is a multiple approach. We decided to go with a 19 multiple just to be a little conservative. We got 269 as a stock value, which makes it a premium of 13% compared to the current price. And then the DCF model over here, we calculated our WACC, which we came up with 6%. We decided to do 6%, and our stock value is 229, and compared to the current price, the discount is 2%. Now Mina will talk about the net asset value.
For our net asset value, our NOI was $415 million. Outstanding shares was a little over $65 million, and we chose cap rate 3%, which gave us a net asset value of $211, premium of 11%, franchise value of $23.
So overall, based on our scenarios, we're giving the best recommendation to scenario two, which is our intrinsic value of $249, which is greater than the current price of $234, and we recommend based on our research to buy.
So here's our recommendation based on our research. We do recommend to buy because of the intrinsic value being a premium of 6%. Because of that, we do, again, recommend that you buy the following trades, the 12 trades. The REIT stock and ETF is buy on margin, buy call options and write put options. And then for the REIT index, buy forwards, buy futures, buy calls on futures, and puts on futures. And here's our references, and that concludes our presentation.